She's a warm fairy in winter. You're right.
We gotta show her around. Let's take her ice sliding.
Come on, Spike.
You are gonna love this.
It sounds fun.
Yeah, great idea. Push the warm fairy down a hill of ice.
Okay, well, wait for me, you guys.
And if you'll be there. Oh.
Today for everyone to enjoy. And of course, in this adventure, we continue to follow Tink, and well, her curiosity takes her into the winter woods where she discovers a magical secret that could, interesting. What's this? Could this be a lost thing? And this? Could this be a found thing? I think Tinkerbell's been here. Keep an eye out, you never know. But for now, to help us dedicate this ice rink, please join me in giving a warm round of applause to two of our resort leaders, Vice President of Resorts and Downtown Disney, along with Downtown Disney's General Manager, Danielle Del Cuo, and Janet Knox.
Hello everyone. I am come from Paris. It's why I need a piece of paper, you know. Do not make any mistakes. It's such a pleasure for me to welcome you for this special occasion. I am very proud to work with a dedicated cast member of Downtown Disney who create happiness for our guests every day. I want to thank them and also Janet. Janet for their creativity and dedication in bringing this new opportunity to you. Now, please welcome my charming colleagues, Janet. And do you know Janet speaks very well French? Can you say ice rink in French?
Voila la patinoire.
Perfect! You can applaud her!
Thank you, Danielle. You know, we're really thrilled for a chance to partner with our friends at Disney Toon Studios to present something brand new for our Downtown Disney guests to enjoy. Playing upon Tinkerbell's discovery of a new world of ice and snow, we thought it would be extra fun to let families and friends have a chance to enjoy a spin on the ice, just like the Disney fairies in Secret of the Wings. And so, this brand new ice rink was created to celebrate the release of Secret of the Wings, and we're so excited to have it officially debut today. Thank you.
Thank you, Janet. And now we have a real treat for you. Two of our very good friends from the Secret of the Wings, two of our filmmakers, are here to join us as well. So please give a warm round of applause for our two friends from Disney Toon Studios, director Peggy Holmes and producer Michael Weigart.
Thank you, Renee. We are so excited to be here for the official opening of the Secret of the Wings Ice Rink.
Yeah, it's so perfect to be here because just like Downtown Disney is bringing ice to Southern California, Secret of the Wings takes Tinkerbell into the winter woods for the very first time in her whole life.
And for the first time, she flies in 3D.
It's pretty awesome. Anyway, Secret of the Wings also brings us a brand new fairy. It's a character named Periwinkle. And she has a very, very special relationship with Tinkerbell. It's her sister.
The movie also has a fantastic new song. The movie also has a fantastic new song called The Great Divide. It really captures the heart and spirit of Tink's adventure into the winter woods. And we're so thrilled that it's performed by the McLean sisters.
Right, they rock. They totally rock.
They do.
I know, right? Anyway, we're going to hand it back to Renee, and he's going to take you back into the world of Tinkerbell and Periwinkle. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So just as in the film, we combine Tinkerbell and Periwinkle's two worlds, this partnership between Downtown Disney and Disney Toon Studios is giving you an opportunity and giving us an opportunity to bring winter woods right here to Southern California. So tonight, I invite you, your family, and your friends to step onto the ice and be that much closer to the magical world and enchanting world of Tinkerbell and her sister Periwinkle. It's kind of magical, isn't it? And what better way to bring on that Disney magic than with a little bit of pixie dust? Who knows? Maybe Tink and Peri might cross that great divide and find their way back here.
What is it like to have something like this in Downtown Disney?
The first year we've done this, we've been wanting to do this for years actually, but this is the first time we were able to do it. And finally, I think we had a good story to tell with Secret of the Wings because of the story of Tinkerbell finding Periwinkle in the winter woods. And if you've seen the trailer, they show ice skating scenes. So I've only seen the trailer because the DVD just released today. So this was a great opportunity to be able to partner with Disney Toon Studios and bring this to life. So far, we opened a couple days ago. We did a little soft opening, kind of quietly opened, and the guests are responding in a really positive way.
Great.
I think what's really nice is, even though it's an activity, it's a little bit of a decompression from everything that happens in the parks and in Downtown Disney. This is just a chance to just enjoy and skate, which is such a nice family activity. And we were really passionate that we wanted real ice and not synthetic ice. And I think, you know, I'm from Colorado, so I grew up like in the snow, but for Southern California to have real ice, there are kids that never get to see ice or snow because it's Southern California. So, you know, they want to touch the ice and they want to feel that, which really you don't realize that this is such a novelty to have. So
exactly.
We think it'll be really successful. people and just a good family opportunity for people to be together and just enjoy. There seems to be something really nostalgic, especially if you grew up ice skating. I think the parents that are coming here, if their kids have never ice skated, there's something that they go, oh, I did that when I was little, so I want my kids to enjoy that as well. So I think it'll be nice.
How long will this be up?
It'll be up through the beginning of January. So what we'll do now is we're just doing the ice rink now, and then as we get closer to the holiday season, we'll actually have some little chalets set up over here that will sell some holiday merchandise and maybe some holiday food. So just a chance for people as they're over here to maybe linger a little bit and do a little bit of holiday shopping and kind of have that market kind of a feel, holiday market. So we'll activate that as we get closer to Christmas, and we'll take that through January.
So kind of like a holiday village.
Holiday Village, and actually my vice president Danielle is from Paris, and holiday villages in Europe are such a big deal.
Right.
I mean, they just pop up in all the big European cities, so I think his vision is maybe this is the beginning of something bigger. We'll see how it goes this year.
That would be awesome.
Wouldn't that be wonderful?
Yeah, it would.
I know, and that really is a novelty here in the U.S. because I think in Europe, where he's from, that's just part of the holiday culture as those villages pop up. So yeah,
very
we'll
nice.
See.
Very
we'll
nice.
See. Yeah, good. So far, do you guys like it?
Yes, yeah.
I do. I was standing out here earlier thinking it needed more theming, and then I realized it was all behind the curtains.
There's something about real characters not being able to be next to character images, so we wanted to make sure we respect the character integrity
right.
and not have that backdrop back there. So,
yeah.
So this will strike, and as soon as we clear this off, we'll have people get out there and start skating.
So you're going to have it open tonight for people?
Yeah, surely. Yeah. We've got some anxious families waiting to get out there and skate.
How long did this take to put together?
Wow, I think we had elves in the middle of the night put this together. From beginning to end, it took about 2 weeks.
Wow.
And that is a very compressed time frame. And this is our first year of doing it, so we learned a lot about what it takes to build an ice rink.
Right.
But I think it came out really well.
It did, it did. So other than magic, how do you keep the ice?
There's a big chiller back
there. Is there?
So the ice is frozen to about 6 degrees. So you can feel the coolness radiating.
I was actually,
this, so.
I was grateful I wasn't wearing a kilt because it would have been a little cold down there.
That's way too much information.
Yeah.
So it'll be cold. And even when those days when it was 99 degrees last week,
right.
it got a little soupy in the middle of the day, but then, you know, it cools down so much at night, especially in the fall. So hopefully if we don't have that kind of extreme heat, we'll be okay.
Yeah, great. Fantastic.
We have a little Zamboni over there that will bring the ice. So the sessions will last about 60 minutes. People can pay for their ticket and they can have about 60 minutes to skate, which really, if you've not ice skated, 60 minutes is a long time. I mean, that's, people come off the ice after 10 minutes and they're like, oh my God, this is like a lot of work. So,
what's the fee for skating?
The fee for skating is for adults, it's $15 and $3 if they want to rent skates, if they don't have their own skates. And for children, it's $12 to skate and get the skate rentals. We do have, for the little kids, we have double-bladed skates. So for the, you know, if they're little, 4 or 5 years old, they can wear the double-bladed, and that seems a little more stable. I told him
I need
those
training wheels on mine. So.
You know those little walkers
right.
that you can push? That's what I need.
I have one.
Yeah, so 15 and 3 plus $12 for a 60-minute skate session. And we should be open most days from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m., maybe 10 p.m., depending on the night, the day of the week. But full operation from now through the holiday season. And as you know, if you've been to Downtown Disney, we're packed during the
Absolutely.
Nights and weekends. So this is just yet another activity for people to do.
That's great.
Yeah.
I have another question.
Yes.
Are there going to be characters that come out and skate with them?
There won't be. I mean, it's
too distracting.
Yeah, it really is. And, you know, this is something that people need to focus on their safety when they're out there skating. So we try to minimize any distractions. What you will see is every 30 minutes, the title song from the movie, the song is called Great Divide, that will come up every 30 minutes, and there'll be a synchronized light show that will play along with the music. So you'll see the light swirl, you'll see little fairy dust and snowflakes on the ice. So that's kind of that wow moment that will happen. That's instead of characters, that's the story that we'll tell. So I think it'll be really charming.
Yeah, it'll be nice. Almost makes me wish I could ice skate.
Well, just enjoy, hopefully you'll stick around and see some families take the ice and It's just really, it's pretty cool to see.
Very nice.
It's really cool if people know how to skate. Then you go, wow, that's pretty amazing.
What was it like being part of this amazing franchise?
Oh, it's awesome. It is such an honor for us to be part of Tinkerbell and her continuing stories in Pixie Hollow. We love it.
Yeah, I mean, just, you know, it's fantastic to see the audience sort of and how they relate to the characters and the magic it brings to their lives. You know, it's really, you're just overwhelmed when you sort of see how moved the girls are and how much they relate to these characters. It's
right.
Awesome.
Yeah, my wife, 48 years old, and she still loves Tinkerbell. And
yeah,
so.
We do too. We love her.
Yeah, great.
We love her.
Any,
we want to know more about her.
Right.
So that's the whole goal, is just to keep finding out things about Tinkerbell and her life and her world.
Right. Are there any plans for future?
We hope so. I mean, Pixie Hall is a great environment, and the characters are fantastic. So, as Peggy says, we want to see more of their stories.
Absolutely. Well, thank you for your time.
Thank you very much.
Just